all the work you had to do to get to where you are now. Let's talk about that.
Showing up. I didn't have a manager, didn't have an agent or anything, and I was like, man, how am I going to get out and share my gift? And so, like, the different open mics, the different auditions, and I just believe, you know, if you know who you are in God, who He's created you to be, when you show up, He will show up with you, and you'll find yourself right where you need to be.
I always tell people, you never know who's in the audience. You never know. Y'all can be singing on stage. I remember I didn't know the head guy of fashion in Kansas City when he came to one of my events. Walked right past the man. But I greeted him at the front when I came in. That's why it's good to always talk to anybody you come in contact with, because you never know who they are. So back to you just believing. What? You didn't give up. You didn't give up. Explain the transition to Kansas City. What made you go to L.A.?
I went to Nashville first. I'm a graduate of Fisk University in Nashville, Tennessee.
Okay.
HBCU.
Can y'all hear him good?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got a
loud
voice. So I left Kansas City, and I didn't want to leave. Like, my parents actually made me leave. And I went to Nashville, and it was the best thing that ever happened to me. I was able to learn a lot about myself as a black man. Learn a lot about my culture, because they don't really teach you that in the public schools in Wyandotte County, Kansas City at the time. I don't know what they're doing now. But I went to Fisk and I became a music major and I became a Jubilee singer. And just understanding music from the beginning of time, like with classical, with Europeanized music, but like African music and Negro spirituals. And it just really gave something to me, not even as an artist, but just as a human being, as a black man. And it enhanced my musicality and my reason to why I sing. Not because I want to please you, I want to touch you. I want to be able to make a difference. I want to be able to tell a story. And because music's infectious. And it's a universal language. And when we decide to use our gifts to be able to impact someone's life, we're doing it for a bigger purpose than ourselves. So that's what moving to Nashville did for me, going to Fisk University. And when I went to LA, it was kind of like, okay, I got the ropes now. I can go to LA, I can do this. And I get there, and I went to this open mic thing, and they had like this intermission where like there was a red light, green light situation. And when the green light comes on, you go to the stage, and you sing if you get the microphone first.
Kind of like tonight, they're not ready for what we're about to do.
Right. Okay. So I went up to the stage and the young lady got there. I was like, oh, okay, cool. Let me get off. So the band didn't know her song, so they said, okay, we'll have Eric come up. And the host, she was drunk, and she was like, I'll get this nigga off the stage. Like, he ain't singing. Like, we're going to have her come onto the stage. She was like, wow, I can't believe people treat people like this.
But it's real though.
Yeah, it's they say what they want to say, and I was just like, okay, it's too early to be doing this, so I just got off the stage. And young lady got up and she sang. I felt bad because she didn't do a good job.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I was like,
listen, y'all wanna have that tonight. Y'all got some good talent tonight.
I was like, oh, precious love. And no jokes here. But no, I felt like God set me down, and He had me watch everybody that got up, and they were amazing, like absolutely amazing, but I felt like He had to tell me, do not be afraid of being in a room full of knives and you're a spoon. Like, be glad that you're a spoon. Like, be the best spoon that you can possibly be in a room full of knives.
And I was going to ask you that next. Y'all give him a hand. That's it. Let me tell you. So, I don't know if y'all know, I used to do gospel music before I did this. And I used to always save us for last. And I got used to it because I knew I had to go through everybody else. But I know when I got there, I know who I was. And I knew my assignment when I got on stage. So they, of course they do, so being around all that talent, I mean, this is stuff, like, I tell them I'm just flooring, I won't give nobody business, but I'm just flooring, because are y'all liking this as an artist, are y'all learning some stuff out there?
Yeah.
So he's worked, so when you see all these great singers, what's to do with the curly afro? Dude can sing.
Devon?
So what I'm asking you, when you get, because I remember, you know, y'all know who Toby White is? She's a gospel singer. Me and her, we grew up in the same church, And I used to be like really scared, because I'm not the best singer. I know who I am. I'm going to entertain you. I'm going to give you a best. I'm going to give you a good show. But I learned that over the years, you got to be you. You got to be unique. So how did you get through like all these great singers? As a singer, how do you stay in your lane?
I think for me, the way that I stayed in my lane is that I stay connected to the source. By me staying connected to my Heavenly Father, I get to know me better in Him. And it allows me to be able to be myself relentlessly. And just knowing that there's no other person like me in the world but me.
That's right.
And all of you are uniquely different. And if you stay into that uniquely different lane that is you, someone will notice you from the crowd.
Somebody's gonna notice you. You can't give up. Number one, y'all. You can't give up, right?
Right.
You gotta hang in there. So my last question, how has Black history changed you? That's what I'm asking. Through this whole series, y'all, I can't wait to go back and look at the tapes, because everybody's going to have a different answer. That's the cool thing about this question. How has Black history changed you?
Black history is, for me, I am an extension of a lineage of strong tower people. And creators, innovators, artists, fighters, soldiers. And to know that if they are all of those different things, then so am I. So that's what Black history is.
Yeah.
Last question, and I'm done. As we got to stand on your feet, and then we got to hear LJ, can you get the, let's get the mic started again. What would you tell every artist out here right now?
I would say, if your dream is whatever it may be, do not give up. There are some different things that you'll have to go to get to that dream. But just know that if you're connected to the source, if you meditate every day on the vision of what I guess God is telling you to do, then you'll find yourself in the right place as you continue to show up in those different arenas. And don't be afraid to be who you are. If you're a spoon, be a spoon. If you're a fork, be a fork. If you're a knife, be a knife. And it's beautiful because someone will notice it and someone will appreciate it.
Thank you.